So with summer coming, a lot of us have trips planned. And when we go on trips, we take photos. And it would be nice to share those with people back home around the world. For years and years, we've been able to just post photo galleries online with all different sorts of websites. Apple's had various different functionalities in iPhoto and now Photos to do that. And it's really quick and easy. If you just want to post some photos that anybody could see, you can create the shared gallery. It's part of iCloud. So here I am in the Photos app on the Mac. And I'm just going to select a few photos just to get started. Let's say I just want to share these. I can add more photos and get rid of others later. So this is just to get started. Now I'm going to go to File and then Share and then choose iCloud Photo Sharing. And on the right here it's going to ask me to choose an album and I can add comments as well. Now I don't have any shared albums created yet, so I'm just going to hit the plus button here to create one and I'm going to give it a name. I can invite people. Inviting people will help me create a private gallery, and you have to have an Apple ID in order to sign on to your account, and you have to match one of these Apple IDs I'm going to add here. But let's talk about just creating just a simple, easy, public one. So I'm just entering a name. I'm not doing anything else. I'm going to hit Create. And it's going to create this. And on the left here I see under Shared Albums there's one album there. And I can go in and I can see the six photos I've added. Now I can easily add more photos to this. I can go to Photos and I can just drag and drop. Let's drag and drop this one and just put it right in there. So now when I go there you can see it's going to update and add the seventh photo to it in a minute here. And then I'll have seven in this gallery. There it goes. Now how do I share this with people? Well, when I'm viewing the shared album here I can click on this little button here and it shows me the name of the shared album. I can change that. I can invite more people. But I can also click on public website. And this just creates a URL here and I can copy and paste that into anything. An email, a post on Facebook, text message, whatever I want. I can post it to my website. And people can actually just use this link and I'll just double click on it to go to it here. And here's what it looks like in Safari. And this will actually work in any web browser. It works on Chrome, Internet Explorer, on Windows computers, on mobile devices. This is just an iCloud little website and you can view the photos. You can click on a photo to go into it. You can flip through them like a slideshow, download photos, all sorts of things. It works just like a pretty full-featured photo gallery. That, you know, something that's been around on the Internet for a long time. But the great thing about this is it's easy to use, easy to set up. And it's free as part of your iCloud account. Of course you're using some space on your iCloud account, but we all get 5 gigs for free. So if you're not using much of that, just a few photos is barely going to touch that. And it'll be easy to put these up. And you can take it down whenever you want. You can see I can select and control click here and delete the shared album when I want. I can also go to the settings button here and I can turn off public website, for instance, for it. All sorts of things. So quick and easy way to just share a bunch of photos with people. The great thing about this though is once you've created it you can continue to add photos to it. So as I take more photos I can drag and drop more photos into this shared album and it will update automatically. And I can do that for my Mac but I can also do it for my iPhone or iPad. And you can do the same thing from your iPhone here. So I'll go into Photos and I'm going to go down to Shared at the bottom. And you can see there's the trip photos I created there. And I can hit the plus button here and add new photos that way. Or I can add them just as I would add them to any other album. So I can be viewing the photos and then say add to the trip photos album. So I can easily update this from my iPhone. In addition to that, if I go up to the top level here of shared, there's a plus button. And I can create a new shared album right from my iPhone. So if I'm only taking my iPhone with me on a trip and I didn't set this album up in advance on my Mac, I could just create it for the first time here on my iPhone and start sharing here. So I will call this one Trip 2. Go to Next. I'm not going to add anybody to that invitation list. But instead I'm going to go into Trip 2. I haven't even added any photos here yet. But at the bottom you can see it says Photos and People. I'll hit People and you can see there's that same public website option. And now I get a link there at the bottom. I even have a Share Link button and I can, you know, copy it or you know send it an email just like that. So it's just as easy to set up on the iPhone or iPad as it is to do on the Mac. And since it's iCloud, it can then be updated from any of those devices. Keep in mind, you do need to have iCloud, of course, turned on. And if you look in the iCloud settings under Photos, there is an option to turn on or off iCloud photo sharing. It's on by default. Make sure you have that turned on or none of these options will show up.